Welcome once again, Grady High School. I'm Nick Gibson alongside Matt Marshall. Welcome to Game Time. We got the rundown for you today, including a girls' soccer preview, night fight, and two head coaches making history in Sunday's big game.
That's right, Nick. But first, we got to get you caught up with an exciting 2 weeks of basketball. So here, like always, Travis and Carson with the highlights.
Knights with another rivalry game, this time against North Atlanta, and
Chris Willis
might need some medicine because that move was sick. What do you think, Carson?
He wants that matchup all day.
Here you can see the Knights, as in previous games, have a problem with easy turnovers. That one leads to an easy bucket on the other side. And as you can see, Carson, the Warriors are just hot right now.
Hibachi indeed.
North Atlanta ends up beating Grady 53-45. Wesley Journey with 9 points, 5 boards, and
heading on into North Atlanta, a big rivalry game. Travis, tell us what you see on the tape.
Well, they are the North Atlanta Warriors, Carson, but after this game, they might just be labeled the North Atlanta Landlords, as they were absolutely owning the paint. And who says that in life you don't get second chances? As you can see here, the ladies' hard work pays off, as that is some buckets.
Knights end up losing this one big.
The Knights' next challenge was against number one in the state, Dunwoody. Carson, why don't you tell us about the offense the Knights have installed here?
The offense is real slow paced. Coach Slade definitely wanted to keep this high-powered Wildcat offense under control. As we see here, the nice opportunity from the offense.
And a good analysis, at the half, the Knights down 26-14, but this is what Dunwoody does best, as their shooters behind the arc are deadly, pinpoint, and accurate. And they start to ball just a little bit out of control, as right here, another Knights costly turnover leads to an easy bucket. Knights lose 67-41. Matt Marshall with 10 points and 9 rebounds.
The boys not the only ones with the big matchup against Dunwoody. You see here the Wildcat defense pressuring the Grady backcourt into a turnover. That defense would prove crucial. Tiffany Platt, the nice pass for sister Tarnisha for the 3-ball. That's good. Number 10 from Dunwoody complained of knee pains earlier in the game. We all know if you ice the knees, you ice the threes.
That's buckets.
The Grady went on to lose this one 56-43.
All right, the boys' basketball team gets started against their rival, Decatur. Pick it up in the fourth quarter. Knights are down 10. Here we have the athleticism of Decatur. Big man get the nice, easy shot in the paint. Now we have Tyrone Norman, second game back from injury, and that is a nice move right there. Knights, however, had a few costly turnovers, and this right here is the exclamation point, as the Knights will eventually fall to Decatur 49-36. Chris Willis led the Knights with 12 points and 3 rebounds.
Decatur fourth quarter, Big T, Tiana Holland forcing the foul. Tiffany Platt, how clutch has she been?
She is like a car shifting from first to second gear. Here she hits the second free throw to put the Knights ahead by 2.
Decatur Bulldogs trying to battle back with a nice down court pass.
No Helen Keller, no miracle worker. Knights win by 2. Matchup against Chamblee. This is a region game, and Josh Williams misses the shot. Chamblee appears to get the rebound, but a nice hustle play by the Grady Knights, and they get the ball back. This is late. This is a big possession. Oh, but that was a little packy shuffle sore. So they are a little boneheaded play that turns into an easy 2 for the other team. However, give the ball to Rico Robinson. What do you think about Rico Robinson, Carson?
Rico Robinson provides mismatches all over the court. You see his quickness, got him open in the corner for the easy 3.
That big 3 tied him up with 31 and a half seconds left, and Mr. Clutch Rico Robinson hits another big shot, puts the Knights ahead 57-55. Clock runs out. Good job, boys.
Well, Nick, it looks like the basketball season is turning itself around just like last year at the right time. Let's hope that continues, but for now, the juniors have had their chance, the seniors have had their chance. Now the sophomores take center stage as they try to prove their worth in this edition of Night Fight.
Welcome back to Game Time's Night Fight. I'm your host, Liza. Today is a sophomore competition day. This will be one long obstacle course. Let's see what teams we have competing today.
Hey, I'm Hannah.
I'm Jordan.
we're the Dutch Masters. Oh, hey, 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 hey,
oh, oh, hey, hey, hey. I'm Gus.
I'm Simone.
And we're $50,000
party
with
danger.
I'm gonna bring out Molly now to explain your obstacles to you.
Alright guys, first you're gonna be getting in your trash bag together, and you're gonna have to jump to the water balloons, and then one person's gonna get out and stay at the water balloons, and the other one is gonna run down to the end in the trash bag. And the person by the water balloons has to throw 5 of them into your partner's bag. And once you get 5 in, and we'll be counting, then you run to your partner, and both of you in the bag will run all the way back to the start.
5. Last year, with a young squad and a new coach, the Grady girls turned it up to the tune of a record-setting appearance in the second round of the state playoffs. This year, as Alex Jocelyn tells us, it's about improvement and, more importantly, respect.
The 2007 girls' soccer season is about to begin. With tryouts officially underway, the girls are trying to start this season as strong as they ended the last. With the graduation of senior captain Kyla Wrench, and arguably one of their strongest players, the new senior captain, Leah Bishop, shares her expectations for the upcoming season without Wrench.
It definitely hurts the team because Kyla was really strong in the back, but I think Arielle can play back there, and I think we can pick up a freshman or two, and I think we have a good chance.
Another problem that has surrounded the team has been the lack of steady coaching.
Freshman year, our coach was not very good. He didn't really help us at all, and then we got a new coach last year, and I think he has really made a big difference.
Coach Rodney Thomas is back for his second year coaching and has been exactly what the girls have needed.
With girls, you have to win their respect. They have to like you to play for you, as opposed to the guys where they want to respect you. They don't have to necessarily like you, but if they respect you, they'll play for you. With girls, it's totally different. They have to like you in order to play for you.
The girls are anxiously awaiting the start of the season so they can prove to the soccer community just how strong they've become. Junior captain Jamison Kinane is ready to help make the undefeated season possible.
I want to help motivate the team to play well this season and just be a good leader and help us play the hard teams better.
With the switch in Grady's region, the girls are looking at a tough season, but with the right amount of training, they seem optimistic and are hoping to make Grady history.
Westminster and Blessed Trinity are the two defending state co-champs, so I'm looking to beat both of them. Actually, I'm looking to beat everybody.
Paideia has generally been Grady's biggest rival in all sports.
Well, my father coaches at Paideia, so ultimately we will beat Paideia.
For junior captain Hannah Rosenbaum, something much greater is at stake than just her school's reputation.
Basically my dignity.
For Game Time, I'm Alex Jocelyn.
February is a month dedicated to acknowledging the many achievements of African Americans. Even to this day, African American history is in the making, as two black head coaches prepare to battle each other for one title of world champion. It marks a great day, not only in sports history, but American history. Game Time's Lardecia Manns has more on the story.
Hey, I'm DC Manns. For those of you who don't watch football, there have been 40 Super Bowls. Super Bowl 41 will mark the first time that an African American head coach has coached a Super Bowl team, making this a very significant event in African American history.
Chicago Bears coach Lovie Smith and Indianapolis Colts coach Tony Dungy are the first African Americans to coach a team to the Super Bowl. Lovie Smith was Tony Dungy's assistant coach at Tampa Bay before he was named as Chicago's first African American head coach in Chicago Bears history. In 2005, Smith was named the Associated Press NFL Coach of the Year. Tony Dungy became an NFL coach in 1981 as an assistant coach for the Pittsburgh Steelers. He later coached for Tampa Bay and was named head coach of the Colts in 2002. Tony Dungy is currently the most winningest head coach with a record of 78-34 from 1999 to 2005. Both men have already made history regardless of who wins on February 4th. Their legacy will continue on beyond Super Bowl 41.
Well, folks, that's it this week for Game Time. I'm Matt Marshall.
I'm Nick Gibson. And if you missed any of the show or you just like to watch us again, go to Google Video. Game Time's online now. Search Grady Game Time. Click on the show. Sit back. Enjoy. Have a great 2 weeks. Enjoy the game this Sunday. We'll see you, Grady.
Before you see me, I got King Kong in the trunk. King Kong, King, 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 King Kong, King, King Kong, King, 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 King Kong. You can hear me before you see me. You can hear me before you see me. You can hear me before you see me. I got King Kong in the trunk. King Kong, King, 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 King Kong, King, King Kong, King, 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 King Kong, King, King Kong, King, 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 King Kong. You can hear me before you see me. King, 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 King,